On this week's episode of the DevOps Lab, we have Hashi back again with a great topic and a new product called Boundary. We're going to be introducing how you can integrate HashiCorp's Boundary into Azure. So tune in. Welcome to this week's episode of the DevOps Lab. With us this week, we have Rosemary Wang from Hashi. Welcome, Rosemary.
Thanks, April. Appreciate being here.
Really excited to have you on the show because I'm a big fan of Hashi. I'm a Hashi ambassador, so I use a lot of your products. And today, I think we're going to start talking about HashiCorp's Boundary product and using that and integrating that into Azure.
Yeah, so Boundary is a pretty newer, newer project. It's an open source project, and it specifically focuses on secure access management. So how does a human access a machine? Which seems simple, but it's not.
Hopefully with a password?
Actually, you might not need a password. And that's kind of the trick, right? Secure access management can be complicated. You have to find the password from somewhere, find the right endpoint, and access it through a VPN. Hopefully, if you are lucky, you have some kind of single sign-on capability. It's pretty complicated. And the reason why it's so challenging is because we don't really have one single view of identity, right? All of our human identities online are linked to multiple types of platforms, environments, and workflows. None of them are consolidated into one. So what Boundary does is it consolidates some of the identity into a single workflow. So what you do is authenticate to Boundary, receive a token, and then you can connect to any target that you're allowed to in Boundary.
Awesome. And that solves a lot of problems for people, especially with working in the cloud when we have various things like connection strings or webhooks we're trying to connect into securely and finding the ways we need to do that. And then also just when we're trying to authenticate into something, you're right. Like there's multiple methods and we're always sitting there going, how do I do this? How do I do that? And if we have a lot of developers on a project or operational teams doing stuff with infrastructure as code or in Azure, we have a lot of secrets to manage.
Yeah, it's definitely intimidating and it's pretty difficult for a developer to bypass that friction, right? Imagine you have to go to all of these different places, collect your passwords everywhere. You have to remember which database password connects to which database endpoint and how you're supposed to connect to it. Maybe your development database is publicly accessible, but your production database isn't. It has to be done over a proxy. So with all of these factors, it makes it difficult to develop quickly or operate your environment with a single point of view and understand which human identity is accessing what target endpoint.
Absolutely. So how does Boundary solve these challenges for us? Because in Azure, again, there's a lot of identity that we have to be concerned about as a developer.
Yeah, so Boundary, I will share a little bit of information about Boundary's architecture and give a little overview as to how it solves it and simplifies it. Cool. Boundary offers what is called a control plane for defining access to endpoints. You can think of this as, let's say an operator can access a virtual machine and a developer can access a database, but a developer can't just access a virtual machine whenever they want to. So when you define it into a Boundary controller, this information gets passed to some workers and a database configuration for Boundary itself. Boundary has a source of truth of access and identity. What happens is that if you're an operator and you want to access a virtual machine, you authenticate to Boundary's controller first. The controller checks that your identity matches whatever identity provider that you want to set up with Boundary, and it allows you to access the virtual machine via a token. So when you get that Boundary token back, you have the ability to access the virtual machine through a worker. A Boundary worker provides access to targets. So you can group workers in different subnets, in different private networks, and selectively allow access to specific machines or target endpoints. It doesn't have to be a virtual machine, for example. You can do any TCP endpoint, like a Microsoft SQL Server database, something that I've configured as part of this particular body of code. So let's actually see this in action, right? You're like, Rosemary, there's an operator. Do they really just have access to this virtual machine? So I'll show you a little bit of some of Boundary right now.
Cool.
Boundary, it has some initial access that I've already set up. So I'll show you what access I've set up. And this is pretty exciting because I've set up three different groups. So the first is an admin group. The admin group uses password access, and what they can do is see every project and every organization in Boundary. Boundary has a domain model where it separates organizations into different groups of people. Perhaps you could have different business units, and then you have different projects. So within the business unit, you might have a couple different types of infrastructure you want to separate. So April, today, you are an admin. You are empowered to be an admin. I know, very exciting, right?
So exciting.
I know. So what I'm going to do is authenticate as April and the admin. So when I log in as April and the admin, and I just have a password, so username and a password, what this allows me to do is check out all of the different projects I have. I have the database infrastructure project and a core infrastructure project. If you look at how I've organized my core infrastructure project, I have a backend target to virtual machines. So anybody who has access to the core infrastructure project can access a virtual machine. They can SSH into it. If they have access to the database infrastructure project, they have access to a managed Microsoft SQL Server database. Seems pretty simple. Yeah. But let's check it out from, let's say, a developer or an operator, right? So someone who is going to use Boundary for some kind of login capability. I've made this easy in that I've actually hooked into Azure Active Directory as an identity service. So what this will do is link up groups within Azure Active Directory to managed groups in Boundary. You'll notice I'm using some HashiCorp Terraform to configure this. You can use any kind of API or CLI call you want to configure Boundary, but it just makes it easier to declare the kind of configuration you want using Terraform. Mm-hmm. So what I'm doing is linking an Azure AD group to a Boundary managed group. And I do that using a managed group filter. So what it will do is it will look at metadata from the JOT of the OIDC authentication method and examine whether or not that group belongs to the Boundary managed group. So it's an overly simplified discussion of what the OIDC authentication method in Boundary does, but allows you to use Boundary with Azure Active Directory and use it as a single sign-on.
And that's all because so many organizations use those groups every time. So then not having to transpose that manually, which is something we often do in a lot of other projects, is really, really helpful.
Exactly. And I think that's the really powerful part about integrating with an identity provider. We're not saying Boundary has to be your identity provider. It's at least offering a way to integrate with other different identity providers across your entire platform, environment, multiple workflows, any kinds of services you want. So to show this, what I'll do is I will sign into Azure Active Directory. What I'm doing is authenticating to Boundary first. So when I authenticate to Boundary first, and I'll show you where this login screen is, we'll move it over. You'll notice I have two identities preset, two users set up. I have a DB admin and then Rosemary Boundary. Let's check out Rosemary Boundary. Rosemary Boundary is part of the operator group, which means theoretically I should be able to SSH into the virtual machine just like April can. So if I SSH into the virtual machine, notice that what I'm doing is using this Boundary Connect SSH command. Mm-hmm. Boundary Connect SSH is a way for you to target the Boundary worker and access the specific group that has the hosts that you have registered. So this is Azure Virtual Machine. I pass a username. That's my username for the virtual machine. And then I also pass the private key here. Very cool. You'll notice this is my virtual machine. Pretty simple.
Awesome. So you're in.
I'm in. Notice I didn't have to find or scramble for usernames and passwords. I just had to log into the machine. Exactly. Now, imagine that I'm the operator and I want to try to access the database. So let me try to access the database. And the difference between the database and the virtual machine is that the virtual machine has a bit of syntactic sugar in the SSH command. It wraps around it for you. When I'm an operator and I try to access the database, notice this is a different target ID. That's the database. Boundary does not let me.
Ooh, not allowed. Denied.
I know, denied. So that's pretty powerful, right? It's saying some group in Azure Active Directory has access to certain services. Other groups may not. And you're able to change that depending on how your organization changes, how your human identities may come in and out of your organization. And more importantly, you actually audit who has accessed it. So if I go back to my boundary here, unfortunately, it seems to have logged me out. So we're going to log back in as April, so April can check out a few things. April the admin.
Okay, I spell my name wrong every single day anyways, so don't feel bad.
It's one of those days. All right, so here we are. You'll notice that a couple of pieces of information here. I don't see any information about sessions initiated. That's because I've already initiated a session through it. Mm-hmm. So if I try to authenticate using, let's say, my operator Active Directory, which it will now ask me to sign in accordingly. So this is the beauty. Exactly. It's the beauty of single sign-on. We can all use this. So as an operator, I'm going to sign in and I'm going to be able to review a couple things. So let's see if maybe let's check out some sessions. Let's try creating a session again. I'm going to connect me. And you'll notice that I have a session now. Boundary is able to audit information about active sessions. Cool. If you're April the admin and you don't necessarily want Rosemary the operator connecting to a VM, you can always click cancel and Boundary will allow you to terminate the connection and clean up the session. So overall, what you're able to do is set up Boundary with any kind of infrastructure's code or configuration tooling that you need, define the groups, link them to an existing identity provider like Azure Active Directory if you want, and control any kind of target access endpoint within Boundary. So anything that anybody wants to access will have to go through Boundary first before they directly access the endpoint.
This is awesome. Rosemary, thank you. So identity is something as a developer, we kind of don't always put at the forefront of when we're developing or we want access to something. So this gives us some really good guardrails to go in and manage our applications and infrastructure stacks as we should. So thank you so much. Really excited to see this new Hashi product out on the market. So thank you for joining the DevOps Lab today.
Thank you very much, April.
Everyone tune in next time for the next episode of the DevOps Lab.